Hello and welcome back in the Sheet Metal Workshop. And in this video I'd like to introduce my latest and newest rounding machine from Swatmans. It's the WSRM031. It's a motorized rounding machine and it works on 230 volt power. So it consumes less power than the older machines. And well, what we have here, also got an emergency button. And also an emergency cord here, so that is a safety. So if I press here, something happens, it stops immediately. And same way, if I touch the cord, it also stops. Now, by pulling it out the bottom and pressing here both of these at once, so it doesn't work now, both at once, I activate it. So I have here two steps, so this one goes forward, this one goes backwards. It's also possible to change the poles if you want to change this, it goes forward or this one backward. That's optional, that's changeable. What we also have here is a speed adjustment, so it goes from 0 until 10. So you can hear it in the voice, at the sound, it goes slower. And now it goes fast. Okay, I normally use it in the middle. Now further also what I have to explain is we have here on this machine, I have here got this grip. This is for changing the diameter. The higher it comes, the smaller the diameter is. And I have here marked for myself on those teats my distance. So I have here distance from 5, 10, 15, 20, and then it's easier to go in between if I want to memorize some setup. Now further I have here also another grip where I can lose this, and it's maybe not recognizable, but from the other side, here you can see maybe moving the under roller going up and down, and that is for the material thickness. So if you're using a 0.5 material thickness, you have to tighten it up, and if it is thicker, for example 1.25 millimeter, because this machine goes up to 1.25 millimeters steel. Now further we have here also this handle here, so if I pull it, I can take it out. So that means if I have really small diameters and it's 1 meter long, a long pipe, I can pull it out. Second thing, what we also have here is we have here also a metal with a screw here on it. If I lose this, this goes down. That means I can make conical rounds. So the side on the screw, this side will be bigger of diameter than the other side. So that's also an optional, what I wanted to explain. Okay, good. Like I've mentioned, I have been testing this machine for a while and I like to give my comments about it. So let's get started. Okay, well, what we're going to do next is we're going to round here, and what very important is how small can it round. So I have tried and tested it. It goes up to 80 millimeter. If you want 1 meter pipe to round it, you will get a small diameter of 80 millimeters. And if you have shorter pieces, well, it can also get 70 millimeters. But I have here an example. This is an 80 millimeter. And we're going to try to round it here. So this is all with protection, nothing can happen. Here I have here my hand, nothing can happen. The rolls, I forgot to mention the rolls, the diameter of the rolls are 55 millimeter, and the distance from the roll until the orange metal is also 5. So we have here, let me say, almost an outside diameter of 70 millimeter. And this is here a metal of piece. And this is here a piece of metal with which has a circumference for 80 millimeter plus 20 millimeter overlap. So I'm gonna make it a little bit quicker here. Now this metal is rubbish, it's oxidized, so that's why I'm using it. It's 0.6 aluminium thickness. And there it is. So here are the holes, and I have here should be 80, so 80 millimeter, and you can here also see the overlap of 20 millimeters. So that is 80 millimeter. I can round the pipe with already. Also, I put a swage in the holes in, so you don't have any problems with 80 millimeter. Definitely will succeed on this machine. Now, if you want to do other materials, thicker materials, for example, like stainless steel, I've got here stainless steel, and that is also got a metal thickness of 1 millimeter. Wait a minute. Okay, 1 millimeter almost, and it also can round stainless steel 1 millimeter. So it goes up to normal steel 1.25, and this is just to show it also works with stainless steel. So I have now here a rounded pipe. I just rounded it. Stainless steel, 1 millimeter. Now what you also can do, I'm gonna slow it down. What you also can do is you can also make it flat again, from round to flat. So I'm gonna demonstrate it. If I wanna have it flat again, turn it around, I have to go maybe 2 or 3 times to make it straight again. So 1 millimeter stainless is possible, but it's different if you have a big production, and if you do it not always. Okay, one more time, last time. And there it is, stainless steel back again, made it flat again. Okay, now I have here another example. If you're making boxes and you have a form, so you have a form like this, so you have here in a quarter circle where a bigger radius is, and then we have a piece of straight, and then comes a smaller radius. So for example, I have here already the circumference of the body, and if I roll it, you see here, this will be then the result. Now, therefore, I'm gonna mark here, from here, this here is my bigger radius, and from this line, I'm have here also a quarter radius from 90 degree. So almost. Okay, that's it. So I have here already now a radius of 90 degree, and the next one, I'm gonna pull the grip down, and now I'm gonna round only between those two lines. And while I'm rounding it, I'm pulling up the grip, so you won't get a kink in between. And that's it. Now you can see here the form is done. You see, and here the plate will fit then exactly on it if you want to close it. So that's also one of those opportunities and possibilities of this machine. Now, next, what we're going to show is a hem. So I have here also metal strip, and I have here an edge of 5 millimeter, and I want to round it, so this edge comes on the inside. For example, let me have a look. See, so this is the result. We call it hemming. I'm gonna pull out the Foley, and now you can see the result. You see, you have here rounded, doesn't matter. Okay, it's gonna be hard if you have really small radius, but from a bigger radius, it's got no problem. It's also possible with steel, stainless steel. I've tested it, so this is just an inside example for hemming. Pieces of metal like a pipe, where you can change here the distance from the third roll here. It goes down, then means this side, the diameter goes a bit, it's bigger, and here the diameter, it stays in what you want. So it all depends on how long the cone is. And well, these are things you have to find out by yourself, by testing. I personally never use it because, well, I always do it by hand and different. And I have here also a piece of metal where I'm going to show. Now you can round it on different ways. You can put it here in, and it goes here by itself, and it will scratch a little bit of the color. Or you just go here in, and if you have problems to move it, I'm just going to lose this one here. So we will see now. See, so I can now move it. Easy. Okay, and there it is. So here is my reducer conical. And like I've mentioned, if you're doing reducers, it also depends on what material thickness you have. And you can set it up here to adjust it here with these toes handles you have here. And then the under roller goes up or down. And that's very practical, because a lot of people don't know and they are struggling it. And you just have here to move it to make more place. And don't forget to look in the video description. There's a link directly to Swatman's machines, where you can look at this machine with all specifications, and also other models of this machine. So there are also bigger with bigger motors, and also with longer rolls if you have to round oversized meters or something. Okay, well, thank you for watching. And don't forget, thumb up, and see you in the next video.